you know, we had done 46.93 miles a day, and then that first day off, I went from, like, the bed to the couch to the hammock, and that was it for the whole day. So we were pretty worn out, and honestly, for me, it felt like I was recovering from surgery. Like, I was just completely wiped out and sore and achy, and it's gotten better every day. You know, I think for me the biggest theme of the summer was how well my husband loved me and how well he served me, honestly. Like, it, you know, I think of the summer and I think it's a love story. Like, yes, it's a story of endurance. Yes, you know, it's an amazing physical accomplishment, but I could have never done it without Brew. And I think you guys could see that in Hot Springs, like all the ways he was integral to the hike. And there was one time up in Vermont, and I think it was the 12th day. In the first 12 days, I'd just been hell. I mean, I had shin splints, we had had bad weather, I had gotten hypothermia, I had gotten very sick on the trail, and I just felt horrible. And at that point, I didn't think I could make it. And he believed in me more than I believed in myself, and convinced me to keep going. And I was so glad he did, because that's what I wanted. And he knew that. No one else knew that. Anyone else would have looked at me and said, yeah, you're done. You're a wreck. You need to get off the trail. And, you know, he's seen me push through tough times before, and he knows what I really wanted, and he knows how hard I worked for it. But he was always positive, always encouraging, and basically just always knew what I needed and didn't complain. He had a really tough job this summer, and had to be selfless and had to be a servant, and he gets very little recognition for it. You know, I think most people come and they talk to me and they want to hear my story and how I did 46 miles a day, but he is totally 50% of this effort, if not more. So I think just really sweet memories of connecting with Brew, of having these knowing looks that we were doing something together that was really hard but really amazing. And then there were certain places on the trail that were really, really special, certain overlooks where there was a sunset, or certain places where I got to see a mama bear and her two cubs, and they clearly weren't scared of me, didn't feel threatened by me, and I just got to watch them and feel like I was really a part of nature. And so there are a lot of times on the trail where I just felt like I was no longer an observer, but I was really a participant in the outdoors. And then I think another really cool thing was getting closer to home and having the friends and having the family and local trail runners come out to help us towards the end, and building on those relationships and feeding off their energy. And then climbing up the last mountain of the trail and having 45 of our closest friends and family there, it was a really, really neat experience. I mean, this was, I feel like, in a lot of ways, a capstone for me. I don't foresee any speed records of this distance or difficulty in the future. I think, you know, we both want to do more traditional backpacking. We'd both love to focus on family, see if we can have kids, and then take them out in the woods too and play with them. So that's the great thing about the trail and the wilderness, is it's there for every stage of life. And we hope to do it as a family, we hope to do it when we're retired. And this was just a really special season when I was 28 and I was an athlete and had all this experience and a great support crew, and I was able to enjoy the trail in a way that very, very few people are able or even willing to experience it. But for me, the speed records are very, very special, and really taught me what I was capable of doing, and allowed me to push the boundaries of what is possible or what is capable. And I think that's a really important thing for people to try if they have the opportunity. I think certain people who are well qualified to break the overall record are very interested in it right now, and I know certain guys have already told me that they'd like to go back either next year or sometime soon to try to break our record. And it's neat because they were like, wow, we just learned a lot from the way you did it. So, you know, I have no pride about my record being broken. Like, I think it's really cool that the record holders are working together in a way to, again, push the limits of what is possible. And I never think that a record holder really stands alone. They're just simply crawling on the shoulders of the people that came before them. And I actually think it would be really cool if Andrew Thompson, whose record I broke, wanted to come back and try it again, because he's still young enough and physically able to the point where if he wanted to come and try it again, I think he would have a good shot at breaking the record.
But you're not going to be
defending
your title?
No. Nope. I'm going to be reclining with my feet up and watching them hurt when they're trying it and enjoying every second of it. So I just think it was really special that we got to go after our dream.